Welcome back to Satisfactory. I am so glad you're here. Last time we definitely talked about that's creepy. We definitely talked about putting together a wire factory, and that's exactly what we're going to do. Once we get some of these artifacts out of the way so we don't get constant call-outs. Okay, so looking at the wire recipe, I think at most we want 782 belts worth times two. So two belts worth would be, all right, hold on, let's stop for a second. The wire that we're making is 30 per minute, okay? And our belts can handle 780 per minute. It's kind of our first clues to what we want to do. 780 divided by 30, and that's divided by 2. Alright, so 780 divided by 30. It's 26 constructors. Times 2, which is 52 constructors. Which almost doesn't matter. What's more important is if we want wire at 780 times 2, that's 1560 and in order to get that level of support we need to generate 3100. No, opposite way. 1560, so back to 780. So one belt of copper ingots would result in two belts of wire. That's the simplest way to think about this thing. Okay. Then we have to go over to copper ingots. We've got a recipe here. The foundry recipe will give us 100 per, so that's just under 8 foundries. All right, well, let's just do that. We'll just feed those. We'll just feed 8 foundries the required good stuff. What I think we want to do, find a foundation that we can use. Oh, I don't have enough space. You know, instead of worrying about the space right now, let's just build. I'm gonna use control click. And I'm using the asphalt scheme for the ground here. Might change it up. A But this is giving us a nice, clear indication where we want to build. Oh. Guy's in the way. What'd I say? 8 foundations? Or 8 foundries, excuse me. Take off some of that top level iron ore. Using the foundry recipe, so we know that takes half the iron. All these resources are normal. This might not allow me to mine through. Let's try it here. Alright, the 3 miners. Production miner 3. Did I mention I had a couple of industrial storage containers out here to help move us along? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, there we go. And then what we'll do is we'll add some stuff that we know we'll probably need back to the mix. I think I'm going to be short on a few things, unfortunately, but we'll worry about that when we get there. Pretty sure these will work. This one, not as sure about. Yeah. It's not snapping. It's a little too far up. I only grabbed 3 miners. I only grabbed 6 miners. I needed 9. Here's what we'll do. We'll try another foundation. But
work.
Probably not. Ooh, perfect. Built this, it was perfectly flat, perfectly clean, but the ravages of time, a little sand dune appeared here and there. All right, beautiful. Let's take a look one more time at the ingot recipe that we're considering. Ten ore. Equals 20. So this doubles up as well. I think that means I can do all of this on one belt. If I entered right here, I might be able to just build a nice little wall. Make it a conveyor hole for two. All right. And then double back over here. Oh, I gotta get my aluminum. Ooh, please. Something to be said for local construction sites. So, you know, I could, if I have the material. So if I don't, then forget it. To tell you that asphalt is the hardest design to build on. You get so few clues. Then maybe a little back. Spider off into the conveyor hole like that, and here I'm gonna do my best not to store anything. First time ever. Well, except for the result. civil merger somewhere along the way here. And I'm going to vote doing it early. Maybe even earlier than that. That's powering up. That's going to give me 480. I don't know. Is that enough? Each one of these is generating 240. That's 480 total. It's less than a whole belt's worth. And then we need to connect this guy to power. You're going to generate 240. So whatever it's whatever's happening, it's happening in the right ratios. So that's something. This is turning into a very gray construction. You know, whenever I don't want... never mind. Invalid? What? If I go to walls... And I could definitely select concrete. Are you gonna make me rebuild this? I guess so. I don't know how far back we're gonna go, but it appears we have a natural limit. For some reason, I want to go one more level up. And then build the floor. I don't know that I'm going to do anything with this space right here. I'm just trying to rise above some of the topographical features that are in this area. Let's put try this for final first. Yeah, see, I don't know if that's perfect. Could be, though. I think I'm going to have to feed from below. One of these resources. Let's grab those. And we're ready to build the boundaries if we have the resources. Original frames. So what am I saying? I'm saying that if I go in here and try to set this up with two rows, it's just going to be a mess. So what I'm basically saying is that we're going to build boundary back a little. This perhaps? And we said we wanted 8. It's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, one short. One, 8. And maybe 9 and 10. Okay, so what I'm suggesting is one, just straight delivery using standard manifold techniques. This might be too close. It's gonna be a little tight. Sorry. Poet, and I don't even know it. The last one of these is going to have to be severely underclocked. First seven are doing 700, but eight just looks better than seven. This is the addition of the second ingredient. I just realized that I did not check to see how much space I needed to process all this. So this might not be perfect or even legitimate at this point. Let's see. If I want to take If I want to make wire, right, then I'm taking one belt worth of iron ingots and turning it into two belts of wire. So 780. I need 15 divided by 780. Or 780 divided by 15. 52 constructors. I'm thinking something like a two row. Of constructors, and then just however many I need. All right. What were the numbers? 52 total. Let's connect this and see what it's like to have... this part rocking and rolling. Can I build this splitter after the fact? Is this connected, is the question. Try it again just in case it works. And alas, it doesn't. Oh, right. I didn't put power in on any of that. Wait, I did put power. I didn't put recipes on it. Let's put the recipes on. So all of these are going to make 100. That's 700. And then this one is going to make 80. Oops. I got you. is build this wall right here. Try to finish this piece off. Then maybe, what do you think? Shall we put a door somewhere on here? Probably needs more than one door. But we'll stick with one for now. One awesome concrete wall door. Alright, so now these are all full. I need 26. No, 52. Direction. It's worth serious consideration. I need a middle. Yeah, see. I don't know that I'm gonna have room for both a merger and a splitter. Oh wait, this is a merger as well. Close quarters. That's okay. Alright, so for every one of these I build, I need to count two. So that's two, four, six, eight, ten, 12. Would make 26. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Wait, one, two, three, four, six, seven, eight, 16. Let's check our numbers. That's not right, I don't think. I think we said we wanted 52 times 30, which is times 2, 78. So that's going to take one belt turn to two. So that's 52 items. Then we want 52 divided by what? 4? So that's 13 per. Oh, 13 per. I'm hearing myself now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is 16. Not 13. And if we go with that, you know, these are really close together. I think I'm gonna give ourselves a little bit of room. Just too close. I think you just have to do the 12, 13 and build two more of these. That's going to be one heck of a manifold. Thank you. get power up here. We'll merge this one down on this belt, or on this foundation. Then we'll merge this one down on this foundation. Straightforward, easy. And generally, I think I want to put the power over here. This is turning into quite the build. Ah, I was wondering why I was acting weird. Uh-oh. That change? Oh no, the same. Somewhere in there, I think that's correct. A classic wire recipe. Uh-oh. We missed a power connection somewhere. Right here. Okay. That's 13 of them ready to go. So my thought would be we'll bring the wire down this way. We'll do something with it there. And then here we'll have to split this. Come in this way and split. Basically like this. I'm in the exact wrong place to have this work. Each one of these is gonna have just a little bit of room to keep making more. Right, so now it comes around here. Then we'll go down the line. No. Oh, okay. Normally, I would say do one thing at a time, but this is almost one thing at a time. Because it's the same item. Thank you. Okay. So now I gotta get this merge down. Suddenly it's like the factory comes alive, all the steam and the pistons. Uh-oh. What have I done? I got them all right except for the last one? Or the first one? Weird. That looks to be what happened. That's done. We need to send the wire on this side down. Like a, I mean, this is definitely one of those situations where a blueprint would probably be welcome. But, I'm torn. Like I said before, there's a sense of accomplishment that comes with doing all that effectively by hand. So this is not flowing nicely. I think it just means that this one still has, it's going down, it's just, it has too much iron in it. Like if we took all the iron out, and we'll double back and put these in the front. Okay, just so it's getting rid of that a little bit. All right. I think when we get to the end here, we need to build up. This done perfectly would be a conveyor wall. But the point that I'm having is that we need to go up a little no matter what. Trying to consider the placement of the next floor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, depending on how you count it. If we said it was 1, 2, 3, 4, we could put the middle here. Seems like it should be more here, though. Something like this. Sorry, trying to think about, like, now that the design is sort of coming together here, we've got a little room for... It might make sense to try to keep this space. Hole right in the middle of this. Bring this up. No, it's not right in the middle. One thing to keep in mind is whatever we do here, we have to effectively do above as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to I need to grab some more materials. Let's see, where's our little construction materials section? Something like that. And, you know, I think I just want to move this back. And then let's put a transport. Right on the edge. Actually, kind of perfect. Let's build the other side of this before we get too far down the road, but I think from a sketching standpoint, that's pretty close. If we can line that up perfectly. Try to get some of these copper ingots upstairs. I think as soon as possible, I need to start making stuff. Like, I'm tempted to not even wait for a full foundation. That's 4, 5, 6, 7. Right, while we're thinking about it, let's go down here and grab this other side of wire. Well, you know, at the very least, we know we could probably do some storage with this one. So let's go ahead. No. Storage check. Storage built in the wrong direction. Check. All right, so now we're making some wire. Need to split this down the line.
Oh, I thought I did it wrong the last time. Split it down the line like that.
These are not perfectly sent. Oh my god. Whole thing is off. Alright, let's make sure we have the first one correct. There. Wait a minute. Okay. It's possible that I've been playing this a little too long, so now I'm doing a whole different kind of a stake. We need to split this down the line. Like that. There we go. Boom. Finally. You know, the classic. Would be this. Point like that. I'm gonna stick with my... Oh, can't clip through the conveyor belt. Put the power pole on the splitter, which then acts as a guide for splitting.
Everybody's about to get power. Drop down a little bit here and turn on the wire. Copy that. Paste it. There we go. Now I need to merge this down. There we go. That side of the wire is done. We'll have to see if these calculations are anywhere near correct. I mean, basically, it have to be though, right? 52 times 15, 780, one belt's worth. So if I'm making one belt's worth of copper ingots, that should turn into two belts worth of copper wire. And that one belt should go straight in like this. Suppose we need power. right? Both these belts consolidate down to one belt, so each one of these is basically half a belt. They get consolidated down into a single container, which then outputs the remaining into the drone port for transportation and distribution. Okay, we're gonna come back down here. We've got one more merger to make. This one's easier because I can just put the orange and the yellow arrows right there on the right together, and I know it's correct. And I just keep an eye on the line above me just to make sure we've got that cross, to ensure we have perfectly aligned. Be a bit of a tight squeeze, but we're going to get it in there. Okay, so now I need... Sorry, I'm whipping the camera around a lot. Let me take a moment. And... I think what I want to do... is go in like this. This one connect on the upper side. And then on this side, it's really easy. Connect at the bottom, and we're done. Shoo! That was a heck of a build. It definitely needs some finishing touches. Like finishing the wall here. Thank you. little bit of Z fighting there, but it's fine. Alright. I think... Do I have the transport drone? No, not the port, just the drone. I need two drones. Have batteries for these. It's a problem. I might hand deliver batteries and then go back over to the mega base and set those drone ports up, and they'll have all the batteries they need. Why are we stopping? Oh. Drone port might be getting full. Well, no, drone ports are not full yet. Right, and the drone is filling up. 4,500 wire per pop. Oh, it's probably just needs to loosen up. Right? So, like, we've got a ton of wire in here already. So, some of these early machines are. Stuck. Let's see if we pull out all the stored up wire. This should work its way through. And then up here. This will be something like copper wire one. And this will be something like copper wire two. I have everything I need to make the last little bit. This is really a long video, but I do want to complete the task, so let me pause. I'll run back to base, I'll get up to where the drone ports are, and then I'll come back. It'll save us a couple minutes. Be right back. Okay, we're back. So this one, can make this copper wire receiver. And then while we're here, we'll grab a couple. More batteries than we could possibly use, but we'll just introduce those batteries as part of our
standard loadout. We'll build one more. Drone port. I'm trying to figure out how to best line this up. It's a little over the edge. But aren't we all these days? Let's see here. I think something like that. Receiver 2. Close that off. Power that up. Let's go down below. Put some batteries in. Guess we should put in our battery connection first. Put some batteries. Right in here. Super easy, super to the point. And since each one of these drone ports has its own connection, should be all set. And that is going to help us make more batteries. Even though right now, looks like we don't need any more wire, but further down the production line, we need more batteries or more wire. I might have to turn down my autosave frequency. Oh! Did not catch the hover error. Alright, all we're gonna do. Boy, see, that's what I wanted to do last time. Just have a nice, gentle landing. This building needs some finalization, but from a pure utility standpoint, we are ready to go. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to slap some batteries in here, even though it's going to get batteries from the other location. And then I'm going to tell you to go to copper wire receiver 1. Yoink. And then I'm going to have you go to copper wire receiver 2. So short trip. Technically, it's probably too short of a trip for drones, but this is what we're doing. I think once we confirm those drones make it there and make it back and take off one more time, we will consider this a success. And then we have just a little extra buffer ready to go out here. Starting to wonder if it's gonna make its way back, though that is potentially me being a little impatient. There's a drone coming back, so it looks like. And there's another one. There we go. Okay. We're calling that a success. We've added 2 belts worth of copper wire to the main bus. It's ready to go. Rip roaring. Let's see if we can get one of those perfect shots. What we would want is the drone on this right drone port to come back, start to land, a full belt of copper wire loading into the drone port. I think that is the thumbnail. Of course, now we have to wait for the drone to come back. Unless the drone pad is full. Oh wait, here it comes. It is going to fill up pretty quickly though. I think the very next episode we're going to have to pull the copper wire into the system. Maybe I can get both of them. All right, we got it. We definitely got it. Should have put my jetpack on. But then I realized I don't have my jetpack on. Ah! Just kind of threw me off. All right. Well, I think that's about it for now. That was a very extended video, almost getting hit by a train. Next episode, we'll jump in there and we'll inject some of that copper wire into some key sections of the mega base. And that will help us increase our production for space elevator parts. That's really the whole point. The whole point of that crazy wire build was to support our space elevator parts. But that is most definitely a video for another day. Uh-oh. Thanks for hanging out. I do appreciate it. And we'll see you next time.